गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. इन टुडे सेशन वी हैव अ डिस्कशन ऑफ फ्लैश इंटरफेस. अ फ्यू डेमोन्स्ट्रेशन वी हैव डन इन प्रीवियस सेशन एंड इन कंटिन्यूएशन टू दैट वील बी डिस्कसिंग फ्लैश इंटरफेस मोर इन डिटेल टुडे इन दिस सेशन एज वेल. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद फ्लैश 8 action script. So when we are talking about a flash 8 action script, so what actually means by action script here means any kind of instructions that are scripted. So action script is the programming language that Micromedia Flash has used from the very beginning and that the Flash 8 uses too. In general, we can say that the action script will allow us to make everything what we propose with Flash 8, since it gives absolute control over everything related to Flash movies, absolutely everything. So by action scripting, आप कोई भी इंस्ट्रक्शंस दे सकते हो. अगर कोई भी मूवी बनानी है उसको आप अपने अकॉर्डिंग फुल्ली कस्टमाइज कर सकते हो एंड एवरीथिंग विल बी डन बाय स्क्रिप्टिंग हियर. सो फ्लैश इज प्रोवाइडेड यू विद ऑल दीज एक्शन स्क्रिप्ट्स एंड दे आर इनबिल्ट. दे मे बी यूज्ड ओवर एंड ओवर अगेन. सो लाइक इन लाइब्रेरी ऑल्सो आपके पास कोड्स हैं, स्क्रिप्ट्स ऑलरेडी पड़ी हुई हैं. ऑल दैट यू नीड टू डू इज to use them according to your suit. So however, in these two themes we are only going to see a small introduction to action script that will serve to set the basis that will allow you to begin working with action script. The programming with action script would require another complete module. So we are not going in detail of programming as such, but I'll be demonstrating you what actually the various tasks that can be used, what are the various tools and timelines, frames with properties, all that are being equipped. And at the back end, they are what? They are actually the action scripts. सो जो भी आप कंट्रोल्स यूज कर रहे हो, जो भी लेयरिंग यूज कर रहे हो, फ्रेम्स यूज कर रहे हो, सो दे ऑल आर द इनबिल्ट एक्शन स्क्रिप्ट्स. आप सिर्फ उनको ड्रैग कर रहे हो और यूज कर रहे हो, क्लिक कर रहे हो एंड यूज कर रहे हो. बट एक्चुअली एट द बैक एंड वी हैव फुल फ्लेज प्रोग्रामिंग, डिफाइंड टास्क फॉर ऑल दोज थिंग्स. सो मूविंग अहेड, there are various characteristics of action script. As we have already commented here, the action script is the programming language typical for Flash. Like we have Micromedia Director, let's say, or the action script is basically based on ECMA script specification. So it works as in ECMA 262, which is other language like JavaScript. So it is more of like programming language where we can incorporate all kind of customization in our animations. The other characteristic of action script here is, as its name indicates, it is scripting language. And this means that to obtain results, the creation of the complete program will not be necessary. Normally, the applications of action script fragments code to the existing objects in our movies allow us to achieve our objectives. So as such, aapko hardcore programming nahi karni hai. Inbuilt modules hai, inbuilt लाइब्रेरी फंक्शंस है, दैट ऑल यू नीड टू यूज हियर. और वो भी सिर्फ ड्रैग एंड ड्रॉप से यूज हो जाएंगे, और यू कैन जस्ट मेक अ क्लिक एंड यूज देम. देर इज नो हार्ड कोर कोडिंग विच इज एसोसिएटेड और प्रोग्रामिंग एसोसिएटेड, बट येस देर आर ऑप्शन ऑफ स्पेसिफिकेशन, देर आर ऑप्शन ऑफ कस्टमाइजेशन दैट वी कैन यूज. So scripting language here, action scripting is a programming language which is oriented to objects. So it is basically object oriented programming language and therefore has similar various similarities with languages such as VB, the basic Visual Microsoft Basic, or Delphi. So they have the various similarities with that. Although evidently it does not have the power of language purely which is object oriented derived from C or Pascal. So each version approaches more to a language of this type. The version 2 recently released in Flash Max 2004 is more powerful and is more object oriented than its previous version, that is 1.0. So they incorporate and support object-oriented feature of programming languages. Apart from this, ActionScript is very similar to the JavaScript. If you use JavaScript, the syntax and the style of ActionScript will seem immediately familiar to you. So you can find the differences between both languages in the help of accompanies Flash. And in most cases, it is not necessary to program indeed. That is what I'm repeating again and again. It is not necessary to program. Flash places at our disposal and impresses collection of functions. So we have all the set of functions in our Flash library. So which are already been implemented. And you can just look for and select the appropriate one and use them. So it will be enough to place them in suitable place. So this is how we can reuse all the functions over and over again, and we don't have to program from scratch at all. So when we are dealing with Flash interface, as I have shown you the interface in yesterday's session as well, we have a menu bar with certain options. So let's discuss what these options are, what are the purpose of these options. So the menu bar entitled us with various options, as in at the top band, you can find the band with options like file, edit, view, insert, modify, text, commands, control, window, help. So this menu bar is aimed to make easier the access to different program features. It is similar to any other web or graphic designer program. So as we have seen in Photoshop as well, the menu bar is providing us with certain options which are quite similar. So the main submenus you can access are like in file. If we are talking about the file option in menu bar, it allows creating, opening and saving archives. So your work, whatsoever the file you are working on, you can create new file, you can open the existing file, and when the work is done, you can save your file. So all these tasks, all these options you can find here in menu bar under the option of file. So import has explicitly power. It inserts to the current movie nearly all type of archives like sounds, videos, images, Flash movies, or the publication setting option from which you can modify the characteristics of the publication. So it also enable to configure the printing pages and print them, etc. So all these options you can find under the option of file in menu bar. Then the second option you can find in your menu bar is the edit. It is classic menu that allows you to cut, copy, paste objects or as well images or frames. It also allows you to customize some of the most important options of your program. So all these options of cut, copy, paste and similar ones you can find under edit. The other option you can find in menu bar is your view. Apart from tropical zooms, it allows you to move the frame and scenes. It also includes the possibility to create a grid and some guides. So it basically works over the kind of view you want to have, whether it is the guided one or the grid one. So all these options you can find under view. The other option you can find in menu bar is insert. It permits you to insert objects into the movie. So whatsoever the animation is you are working on, you can insert any new frame, layers, actions, scenes to your movie. So this way insert helps you. Apart from this, you have the option of modify. The option like transform permits only to modify the graphic existing in the movie, and the option draw bitmap allows you to modify current graphics in vector maps. So other options allow you to modify characteristics of the animation elements, like you can have the option of smooth, optimize, or the same movie layer scenes. All these options you can find under modify, and it provides you basically the scene modifications or the layer modification options. Then the next option you can find under menu bar is your text. Its content affects the addition of text. So it will be further handled more detail, like the kind of text, its opacity, the text family. All these options are featured under this particular category. So you can find all the options in this. And apart from this, you can find the option in menu bar with commands. So basically, command allow the administrating the commands, like group of saved sentences that allow to emulate what users can introduce to the edition environment. So they basically help you to make notes. So moreover, if you are using the inbuilt functions, you can make a command to them. So you can basically edit the environment. You can introduce new features by using commands to particular functionality of a tool or a script. So that we have saved in our animation. To obtain other news from the micromedia pages or execute what we already have. So hamare paas already jo functions hai, unko kuch additional functionality dene ke liye, kuch add-on features dene ke liye, hum commands use karte hain. Jo bhi program hai, usme hum aur nayi commands embed kar dete hain taki overall functionality jo hai, uska result change ho jaye. So this is the basic task of commands that are provided here. And then we have the option of control. From here, you modify the properties of the movie, reproduction, play, rewind, test movie. So all these things can be done from the command, from the control option. Apart from this, we have the option of windows. Like in the previous session also, I have shown you various windows panels that are available, especially in the right corner of the screen. So it is featured with all the panels, and you can anytime open to particular window that is of your concern. You can close these panels. So in addition to the classical options of distributing the windows, this menu includes shortcut to all the
panels as well. So apart from this, we have the help option in the menu bar. From here, you can access to all the help that Micromedia offers to us, from the current manual up to the action script. So you can have all the descriptions and definitions of all the controls or tools that are equipped in Flash. So that you can find under help. Apart from this, we have timeline. The timeline here represents a simple mode of visualization. It consists of two parts. One is frames and the other one is number of frames. So as I have shown you the timeline in the Flash environment as well, the frames here that are limited by vertical line and forming the rectangular band, and the number of frames that allow us to know the assigned number of each frame, its duration, and when it will appear in the movie. So these all specifications and details have been found in timeline. Apart from this, we have the concept of layers in Flash animation as well, as we have done in Photoshop. So it is quite similar to that. So we generate a layer by layer animation, and we can apply any kind of effects or the transformation over one particular layer that will be represented over our whole animation file. So even in we are having one session for that in today lab as well. So we'll be discussing how we can animate with the help of layers. So we'll be discussing, and I'll provide you one demonstration over the same. So basically, the concept of layer is basic to manage Flash efficiency, and because of its importance, we will dedicate an entire until to it. So even so, a layer could be defined as one independent movie of only one level. So that is to say, one layer contains its own timeline with endless frames, and the objects that are at one layer share a frame, and due to this, they can get mixed up among themselves. So frequently, it could be interesting, but not like other times it is convenient to separate the objects in order that they do not interfere among them. So we have to see, we have to check when to use the layers and when to mix up, or when we have to separate these objects to get the better effective results. So accordingly, we make the use of layers. So apart from this, we have the various views like zoom. So zoom tool is also there and is used to approach or move away the object view. So allowing to include more or less zone of your work area. As we know, every time we click on the zoom tool, we duplicate the percentage which indicates in the zoom panel. So just to zoom in and out, we basically use this zoom tool, and all the necessary details you can find in zoom panel, like how much zoom is there, you want to reduce the zoom or you can increase. So all these options you can find under zoom panel. So this is all about the menu bar that is being provided you by the Flash environment. Apart from this, we have certain panels. So we have various panels. So basically, the panels are command set grouped according to their function. For example, all the marks reference to the action will be in the action panel, and it's specifically used to simplify and facilitate the commands that are used. So similarly, we have various panels in with different kind of panels that are the windows. So the first one, we are having the align panel. It places the object like we indicate to it. It is very useful. And then apart from this, we have color mix panel. It using this panel, we can create the colors that we like to, or we can have mix of them. Then we have color swatches panel. It allow us to select a color quickly and graphically. No mixing or any other things we need to include. Simply, we have the color chart and we can select any appropriate color. And apart from this, we have info panel. It shows the size and the coordinate, and this and it coordinates to the selected objects. And with the possibility of modification, it is very useful to for exact alignment. So all the information related to your work area or your image that is being provided here, along with the positioning, like your objects are placed at x axis or y axis, so at what location they are being placed. So all these information are being provided here. Then we have a scene panel. So it modifies the attributes of the scene that we use. And if you still do not know here the scene, so I'll show you in your lab session as well. All right. So then we have transform panel. So it scales, shrinks, rotate, basically transform your selected object. So all the transformation you want to make over one particular object, that can be done by using the transform tool, and all the required information related to these transformations you can find in transform panel. Then we have actions panel. It is helpful when you use action scripts, as we have done in Photoshop as well. So we have the action window over there. You can find or record all your actions, and then you can re-perform them with a very easy process. So this way action panel is used. Then we have a behavior panel. They allow one to assign the certain objects or series of characteristics that are the behaviors that could be stored to be applied to other objects as well. Then we have components panel. It allows us to access to the already constructed and ready to be used components. So we have very intelligent objects equipped in this component panel, like the utilities of calendars, scrolls, or all can be done. And we can find all these features under component panel. Apart from this, we have strings panel. And Flash 8 contributes multi language base to our movie through this panel. So we can switch to or work with multiple languages, and all the support related to that can be found under strings panel. And then we have help panel. So we provide you the help and accessible advices under this particular window or panel. Then we have properties panel. So properties panel do what? Properties panel provides you all the properties related to the tools you are selecting or working with. So all the related information related to your particular object or particular tool are provided in this particular panel. Then we have Movie Explorer panel. It allows us to access to all the movie content easily and quickly. So all the options related to the movie content can be provided under this panel, and you can make use of all very effectively in a very easy manner. So what you actually have to do is you just have to select these properties, alter these properties, and make the changes. So we are having a few more options, like we are having toolbars and the basic tools. And we'll be continue this discussion in our next session. So this is all for today's discussion. In today's discussion, we have discussed about the Flash Action Script. What is actually Flash Action Script? What are the various characteristics of Action Script? Then we had a discussion over the menu bar provided by Flash and the various panels. And we will continue our discussion in our next session. So as of now, if anyone is having any kind of doubt, may ask the questions.